So in today's video, I'm going to do another portrait, but this time I'm going to do it in watercolour. So I haven't done one of these for a while. I've done a lot of oil portraits lately, but not so many watercolour ones. So I'm working on some Archer's paper here on a block, so it's obviously stays flat. It's a rough paper, and I've just drawn my two lines, the plumb line going down, horizontal line going across, which relates to the reference. If I just show you the reference that I'll be using. So the reference I'm using today is this photograph here. I'll put the credit for the photograph in the description and the comments. It's just on a portrait reference site. So what I've done is I've just put a plumb line down and a horizontal line across. Fairly arbitrarily, one down through the eye and the nose in the corner of the mouth, and one under the chin. And the one under the chin I'm going to use to measure up all the distances, like to the mouth, to the nose, to the eye, to the eyebrow, forehead. And from the one across, I'm going to be measuring horizontally to get the distances correct that way. Once I've got everything roughly in place, then I can start to flesh it out. So that's the plan of the drawing. So the other useful tool that I'm going to be using today, well, a couple of tools, is on the drawing anyway, is a putty rubber. And I've got my scaling dividers. So these are proportional dividers or scaling dividers, depending on what you call them. I've already set the scale. It's slightly bigger than the reference, so I'm going to be filling up most of the page with this. And then I'm just using a B pencil here, nothing too heavy. So the first couple of measurements then are just to establish some key points or some points that I can work out from. And really what I'm looking for is just various shapes. So I'm just going to measure out from the plumb line just to where the hair on her neck is starting. And just make a little mark. And then that is actually just checking the angle. So it's going up, uphill towards her face. So just measuring out to the hair on the right hand side of the face. So all of these measurements are really just to proportion where I put my lines, once I start to bring the lines into the drawing. If you're not so confident with your drawing, then you could do this on some separate drawing paper and then trace it across. Because really you don't want to be rubbing out too much on your watercolour paper, as it can rough up the surface. So the top of the head is actually going slightly out of the paper, so that's fine. Yeah, it's off the board, that's fine. Measure across to the other side. So now the initial part of the drawing, obviously the drawing is going to continue with the painting, but now the initial part of the pencil drawing is done, I'm going to start the painting process. And the first thing I'm going to do is to block in a large wash, fairly light, but the largest washes that I can get away with in the first stages. So what I'm going to do is just start to wet, just put some water on the edges of my shadows, because the first colours I'm going to put down are the darker colours. In the sort of the hairline and so on, and I want to give it some room to creep into these areas. So I'm just giving it a soft edge, which will get painted into. So they're coming all the way down. down. I'm not going to go into the face too far on that left hand side. Just bring that down a little bit more under the chin, because the chin is very, very soft. And just let it bleed out of the picture there. And just put a bit more water back in there just to keep it moist whilst I mix up a colour. So I want a sort of a greyish, brownish grey to start off with as a base colour, slightly on the blue side, soft. So here we go. So starting at the top. So I'm not worrying about the hairline. I'm just going to go over the whole thing. It's going to run a bit because obviously I've got quite a steep board here, which is fine. And essentially I'm just blocking in everything but the face itself. So I'll just let that run nicely all the way down, even coming under the jawline a bit to link it all together. Keep it all nice and soft. Okay, a bit more blue. A few more streaks of blue here and there. Perhaps around the edges of the head while it's still wet. A little bit under the chin. So if I've gone too far, then I'm just going to take a soft damp brush just to soften the edge off. I'm just dunking it in some water and then just tidy up these edges a little bit so they stay really nice and soft when I start to bring these other colours into them. What I really want to try and avoid is some very, very hard edges when I start to bring the skin tones into it. So just keep it all nice and soft there, up to the hairline. Because obviously a lot of these shadows are going to be very, very soft. A very light skin tone colour, I should say, as a starting point. I'm going to use some, a little bit of alizarin crimson, perhaps a tiny bit of permanent rose, which is very pink, a little bit of the cerulean blue in that, and a tiny bit of yellow. And then while I'm waiting for this other wash to dry, I'm just going to start to cut in some of this colour in the head onto dry paper. Sort of comes down, trying to preserve some of the, or I will preserve some of the whiter bits of the paper for the shadows. I just want to start to get some colour on. I'm going to get over that eyebrow, and as we're coming down, so where that colour I've just put on, I'm just going to just work the edge of the colour just to stop it getting too hard. And then I can continue that on and through. So over all of this shadow. Coming down the face. It very soft in the middle here, because there's not bring that up into the other eyebrow, just work that colour together a bit. continuing down through the eye fold. It's going to be a very warm area underneath the eye there. Just soften that off. Some of these warmer colours up in the forehead. It needs to be very, very dilute colour up here because the skin is actually almost white. Very little colour in there. So I just want to almost just tint it. Tint the white paper. Bit of white showing there. Might even bring a bit of blue, a bit of cerulean blue, very light wash into that colour in places. Eyebrow there. Even come down a little bit into the eye. Just helps to neutralize some of the warmth in that initial wash. Being a very cool blue, the cerulean. Helps to just temper some of the colours. A bit more of the brownier colour again, just in here, because it's a bit more, there's a bit more value in the forehead and the under part of the, where the ridge of the nose turns down. Back into those browny colours. Just on the edge of this eye over here, it's quite brown. Just work some of that in. Have some of that on this side. Under the eye. Start to develop that shape, the wing of the nose. A little bit more red as we're starting to get into the nose area. A bit warmer on the edge of the shadow. More of the cerulean, just to cool some of that down. Put a bit of the red in that cerulean just to purple it slightly. To get the edge of that nose in. Bit of the philtrum. Get some of this underlip in. Needs to go slightly more green, so a bit more yellow into the blue. just start to develop this shape. A little bit of water just on the edge. Just keep the edge nice and soft. Edge of the nose there needs softening a bit. And make that a bit softer, that line. Continuing to build up a bit more tone in and around the edge of the face. So I'm going to put a bit more water just so I can start to develop these warmer colours on the edge before they go out into the hairline. Down into the jawline where it goes a bit more bluey, greeny kind of colours. Just lose the line there. Just going to continue this shape round. Down into the chin. More blue. Let that shadow come up into the lip slightly, and then up the side of the face. Bring it into the lip there a bit, and then it's very, very light coming off of the wing of the nose. A very light sort of yellowy grey type colour. I'm going to start to develop that shape coming out and down. Comes into the corner of the mouth, all the way up. Forms the right hand side of the philtrum. And this shadow shape can just continue up and away, just mixing a few different colours, like a bit of yellow, a bit of red in there. Just continue that down, a bit more red, as we take that away into the hairline. Right the way up into that existing piece of colour. Knock those edges down a bit. A bit more red. So coming off of the eye here. It's a bit warmer. And then I can get this little shape in under the eye here, which is also very warm. Probably could be a bit warmer than that. More yellow. Probably too warm now. More orange in it. also take that up into the eye a bit. There's the orangey colours. Follow that through into this eye a touch. Okay, now I'm just going to bring some very light washes now into the cheek and the skin around the jawline. So plenty of water in this because I don't want it to be too sharp. So the actual cheekbone comes down this way, a bit more yellow, and kind of meets up with the wing of the nose there, and comes down, goes slightly green now, a bit of viridian, just a little bit, down the cheek. Towards the jaw. I can bring that up to the mouth. A few little marks there, just in the chin. Too heavy that mark. Let's knock that one down. And the chin could come a bit warmer. So a bit of red, a bit of cerulean. Just to get this a bit stronger underneath the chin. Yellow. More red in the chin itself. Some reds, pinker colours onto this side of the face. Again, just onto dry paper. Blue, just to work that into the existing wash. Just let that disappear down the side there into the hairline. Let that dry off. Okay, now just some very light yellowy, very, very pale yellow washes. And a bit of tone underneath the eye. Touch of cerulean. Bring some of that up into the eye fold as well. Of that into the eyebrow, just the cerulean. Some cerulean on this side as well. brown in that cerulean. And then I can start to look at developing the shapes coming off of the eyelash or the eyebrow. So this starts to come down into the eye socket. Just keep that nice and soft. It's a very, very soft shadow. And a bit of dark on this side, so just the brown and the blue together. A little bit more cerulean in this eye. It's a tiny bit of light just hitting the corner of that eye. And I can also bring some of that blue into this eye. Just to start to develop the shape of the eyes. Now I'm just going to change brush to one with a bit more of a point. That was a flat brush. So now I'm going to take some of the permanent rose. Still fairly light, so I've got plenty of room to go stronger. I'm going to get some indications of where the tear ducts are. So that I can actually start to shape up the eyes a little bit. That sort of comes down. I'm just going to wash that out as it sort of makes its way down the eye. Get slightly more yellow, a bit of the yellowy, bluey, grey colours that I was using before. Just to turn that edge, start to get a bit of the eye fold in. And we got a bit of shadow under the eye here. Which continues up and joins up with the rest of the shadow. So it turns down, goes away into the hairline. Knock those edges down. So just giving the whole painting a good dry off, just to flatten out the paper again, and just to make sure that the next washes I put on are not going to push around the ones that are already on there too much. So I'm going to start to detail up the, or get some work into that left hand eye. So I'm just making up a very neutral grey at the moment, sort of a bluey grey, again a very pale wash, and this is just to draw with and to establish some of the areas that I need to work on. So I'm actually going to look to find the pupil, which is going to come about here to about there. Start to establish where that comes in. And the base of it is about there. And then we've got some shadowier colours over the eye fold, or eyelash I should say, coming down. And that comes in to where the cornea is, and I can take that shadow all the way out to the eyelash. Now I'm going to change brush to something a bit more pointy. Let's use my rigger. So now I'm going to dip into, she's got brown eyes. So I'm just going to take some burnt umber to start off with. Might even put a little bit of burnt sienna in there, just to warm it up. Still using it very, very light. And then I'm going to start to bring some of this colour. In fact, I might just put a bit of moisture in the eye shape first. So we've got a highlight here, so I'm not going to keep that dry and just wet the rest of the pupil shape. And from the top, just start to drop in some of this brown, just to get the eye started. Lose a little bit of that at the bottom. Just keep the edge of the eye very soft. Not meant to be too sharp. Okay, it's probably enough for the first wash on that side. So let's move over to the right hand eye. And do a similar treatment. So a bit of cerulean and the brown together. Again, very washy, just so I can establish some shapes. So this is to get the start of the eye fold in, and then we've got the pupil about here, and that comes, well, it's in the shadow, so sort of comes around. Don't really want to paint that too much because that's all in shadow. It sort of comes down to about there. Just make sure they roughly line up. And then I'm going to put some moisture in there again. But on this side, I will just let that fade out into the shadow all the way through there so that the brown can mix with. I forgot my little highlight, but never mind. So that the brown can mix into the shadow. So I'm going to bring those shadow colours, which are going to be a bit more blue and or slightly more purple actually. So some cerulean, a bit of blue, and it's like a bit of grey in there as well that I've just dropped in, just to start to merge those colours together. Try and keep the shape reasonably correct. So that can merge with the under eye fold. There's a tiny little bit of light I'm trying to keep just on that eyelid. And we'll let that just merge out. I just want to soften off this side of the eye. Don't want it too sharp there. So now that I've got those in, I just want to check that they are in the right place, so I'm going to look in the mirror. So I've just dried the eyes off, and then now I can start to add a bit more tone to them. So taking a bit of water, I'm just going to draw with the water a little bit of the eyelash coming down into the centre of the pupil, And then I'm going to take some burnt umber again, and this time I'm going to put a little bit of indigo in it to darken it. So it's a really quite nice, a nice dark. Still putting some water in that paint, so it's not as dark as it could be. But it is a dark. And then I can start to drop some of this in to establish, or start to establish, the stronger elements within the eye, some of the stronger elements. Don't want to overdo that, just want to let it start, and then just use a bit of water to pull that out a bit. Keep it really nice and soft, because obviously we want that glassy type of look to the eye. So I'm going to keep that very soft there. Do the same thing on this left hand eye, trying to remember to keep the highlight this time. So there's a bit of a highlight at the top of the eye. A bit of moisture into the centre of the pupil, and then I can drop the colour in and let it run round the eye. Just take some water to soften that off. Just so that the eyes aren't too sharp just yet. Obviously, I will have to commit at some point to make them a bit sharper. But for the moment, I want to keep it very soft. Just build it up slowly. Now, I'm going to take some water again and just start to build up a little bit of the eyelash on this right. I'm going to take the same indigo and the brown and put the tiniest bit of opera rose in it just to warm it up. So it's like a very dark purpley brown. So I'm just going to start to bring some of this, again, pretty light, so I'm not overcommitting myself, but just to start to get some shape into the eyebrow. And then bring that down just with some water in my brush. Eyebrow just disappears then into the shadow, so I can just use water just to diffuse that so it disappears, because in the shadow I don't really want to be defining too much edge, because it will just break the illusion of it being a shadow. I just want to have some suggestion that it just disappears. Now moving back to the left hand eyebrow, again a bit of moisture, so just water in my brush, taking that same dark and then start to drop that in the same way. again, just wash it out on this left hand side. And then just softly diffuse the bottom edge so it's nice and soft. And then I can continue that colour quite a dark part to the eyebrow just there, so I'm just going to let that become soft on the edge and then dip into something a bit warmer and put that in the same, so using like a yellowy orange, put a bit of that in that same dark brown colour so I can start to bring the shape down a bit more. Burnt sienna in that, it's not quite warm enough. So a bit of burnt sienna just to warm that up a bit more. And then just using water on the edge just to work that colour out and into what's already there, just to diffuse the edge. You can take a little bit of blue of the the cerulean blue, just where we're coming down near the tear duct, it goes slightly bluer. Just drop some of that in to that wash. Work that back up. And even bring that out. It's a bit more of that blue. I'm even going to wash using some water, just wash that out a little bit there and stretch the colour so it's very, very pale, almost just staining the paper. Just wash that away so I don't end up with too sharp a line there. And then dipping back into my warm colours on the edge of the nose here, it starts to warm up a bit, so I'm going to bring this down the nostril across, just keeping a little bit of that highlight on the end of the nose. And it sort of turns the corner there a bit. Goes a bit bluer, bluey purple under the nose, so through this area across to the bulbous part and then up. Just soften that off. Bring that down a little bit in towards the lip, go into some pinker colours now, get a bit of slightly stronger colour in the eyes or near the eyes, so a bit of the permanent rose and some transparent yellow. In fact, I might just dry this off before I do that. So now that's nice and dry. So again, taking that permanent rose and some of the transparent yellow, and use that then to start to shape up the eye a little bit more. So where some of these more prominent warm colours are, just going to get some of those in. Even start to define where the eye fold comes around the eye. And then using a little bit more yellow into that same mix, so it's a bit more orangey. Going to then start to work the edge of the shadow around the eye to take a bit of moisture, and then working out from the eyelash, which is going to come a lot darker eventually. Just going to pull that colour up towards the eyebrow, and that can go a bit browner, maybe a little bit of indigo in that shadow. So just a touch of indigo there to start to pull out some of those darker elements. May even just drop a bit of that into the eyelash, just a few spots. And then continue that colour down. And just let it disappear away into the hair. And then as it comes to the cheek, I'm just going to warm up the edge of that shadow. Bring that down the eye a little bit. Around the cheekbone, more of the permanent rose. Drop a touch of that into the cheek. Wash that out down the face. Bring a little bit more of the yellowy browns, or the yellowy greens I should say, into that colour. And then work that out into the hair, down into the jawline and the neck, so link it all together. Just going to wash some of that away to keep the cheek nice and light. Touch of that green just up here as well. Little bit under the eye, darken up the some of these areas just a touch. Use a bit of green in there. It's always good to counter the reds with a bit of green. Just in the eye here. Bottom of the pupil. A little bit on the left. Just to tie it all together. A little bit on the eyelash, the eyebrow. Few strokes here and there. In the forehead. Coming back to the warmer colours. Just to get this to turn the forehead up into that shadow. Wash a little bit out here, it's quite light there. I'm going to bring a touch more of the indigo and the burnt sienna on the hairline, just up here, just to start to form bit of that hairline whilst that paint's still wet. Trying not to kill all of the under grey colours that I've already got, which are quite nice. Bring a little bit of that out into the eyebrow. Just work that in. We've actually got hair coming all the way up. It's about there. And also back this way. Bring something a little bit warmer on that shadow edge. It's a bit of indigo and a bit of the upper rose. Oh, sorry, the permanent rose, for a nice purpley colour. And then warm that up with a bit of orange, or yellow. Bit of transparent that. Just to work that down into the forehead. And then I'm just going to soften that off. Okay. Just need to turn that edge a little bit more there. Let that colour come down the forehead a little bit. Might even take a little bit of that same purple and the yellow in it. Drop some of that into the eye here. So it's quite a nice combination of colour. Start to get this eye a bit sharper. Bit of water into the pupil. Centre of the pupil, and I'm going to do browny purple and yellow. Start to bring that through the eye. A little bit of water again, just to soften these edges. Keep that glassy effect. Perhaps just a tiny bit of that in the eyebrow. Work that in. Then moving over to this right hand eye. Again, a bit of moisture. Start to bring this into the eye fold, eyelash, I should say, eye fold, eyelash. The same browny purple. And then just let that disappear away into that shadow. And then a bit of moisture again into the eye. Drop some of that nice dark colour in there. Again, just feather the edge of it to keep the softness or the glass effect within the eye. So just using some water. It's a bit darker. Just over this part. Just adding a bit more tone into that wash. Just going to pull that out down towards the tear duct and then allow that to just creep in a bit. Same on this side, just bring a bit more of that dark down, dark purple on the top of the tear duct. Tiny bit more dark just at the corner of the eye on this side. Just wash that in. Going to let that fade out a bit more into the shadow. With a little bit more of a redder tone. It's a bit more of the rose, opera rose colour, as the eye turns up into that area. Bring a little bit more warmth in there. Work that in. Touch more red just in the eye there. And then the under eye can come a bit more colourful. So under here I need to get a bit more tone. Lose a little bit of that under eye area. It's a bit too big. Pull that shadow out. Get a bit of the blue, the cerulean blue. Pull that shadow across then. A bit more red. Then we've got the edge of the hair coming in, and then the eyebrow, so then a bit of indigo, burnt sienna, just work that into the edge. Just soften this off. So bring the eyebrow into that afterwards. Just going to cut into this edge a bit, stop it being so sharp. A little bit of that indigo just in the eye here. Okay, now I need to dry that off a few strokes. So I'm going to take some indigo and the burnt umber. Or burnt umber. Use it a little bit stronger. And then start to figure out where the hair is actually coming, comes out from the crest of the head, starts to turn over. Down the forehead, leaving a few lighter patches coming all the way down and sort of comes out at that point. Here it curves back in, a bit more indigo in the brown. It's pretty dark in this point as it comes back towards the face, and then up. From the hairline at the top, it's pretty dark, and coming out back the other way. Comes around, down. Down the face pretty strongly. It's quite a strong line as it meanders down and comes around the jaw and then works its way back again. A bit more indigo in that. A bit of burnt sienna as well, nice and strong. Coming down from the top. Cutting through the line there. As you come down the face, it's very dark in these elements. Letting it break a little bit in the dry paper. And then while that's still fairly wet, I'm going to take some purple and indigo. Want to in places darken up the background a touch to get the two colours to work together. Pull some of that colour, a bit of yellow, slightly more green, greeny red, still fairly dark but not as dark. Just start to cut in under the chin. So that doesn't get too isolated. Make that nice and soft where the neckline is. And then I just need to soften off this edge of the chin. And just take down a few of these edges. Where the face and the hair meet. Just a little bit of lifting out, just to get a few few highlights in the hair. Not too many. Okay, and then I'm going to dry that off. So now I've got all that nice dark hair on, I can see the tones in the face a bit clearer and see where I need to go darker and lighter. With the painting, I'm going to start to work these edges a bit more to get the skin to turn round into the hairline a bit better. So I need to darken up some of these elements to get the form to turn over. Break these edges up a bit. Need to come a lot darker in the eyebrow. So bringing some more tone into the eyebrow. Our washing. Continue that down. Into the eye. The eye is pretty dark on that edge. As it comes round and then down. And then I can continue that down the side of the face. And then down here at the chin line. Bit more indigo and the perhaps a little bit of light red. So working a bit more dark under the chin line. This is a very, very slight change in angle there. And then I need to pull that colour up into the cheek to make this a whole, this shadow a lot bigger. So using some moisture. Just working these colours in. Perhaps a little bit more cerulean into that. A bit more red. So the cheekbone kind of comes out a little bit more there. Needs to come a bit more red on that edge. Comes across to the nose. Work that edge a bit softer. Continue that down into the shadow. Become a bit greyer. pull that up to the edge of the mouth. Kind of comes across, down. Just soften some of these edges. Make this a bit softer. I'm just doing a little bit of lifting out there. Not too much, just a little bit, just to play with the tone a tiny bit. So down the side of the nose needs to come a little bit lighter. So just lifting out a little bit of colour there. Back to the warmer browns. A bit more water. So as it comes up towards the corner of the eye, it starts to get a bit more purple. There's a lot more purple up here. And then I can pull that up into the eyebrow. And then start to soften the edge a bit. A little bit of that purple. A bit more blue actually. Into the nose. And then just soften all that off. Bit too much moisture there. Bit more light red. Onto the nose. And pull that through. And then go into more of a pinkier red. A little bit more of the permanent rose and some of the blue, cerulean blue. Just to turn that edge, start to get the nose a bit darker on this side. Can even use a little bit of that same colour into the nostril. Soften that off, it's a bit too dark there. It needs to come out a bit as well. A bit more orange, orangey brown. Green, Viridian, just to get that edge to come down into the cheek. It's a bit too dark, a bit more water. Brown spots here and there. Slightly more blue. A little bit warmer again. Down into the chin. A more red. And then back into the cheek, a little bit more of the light red. As it comes down the face, a bit more of the bluey greens. Particularly where it comes into the hairline. Meridian around the mouth and the light red. Can even start to bring some of that red into the lips, a little bit more of the permanent rose. It's quite a warm few tones in the mouth. Not quite as strong as that there, though. So then the mouth here has got a bit more tone to it, slightly grey. Sort of a grey shape as it comes up into the lower part of the lip. And then it's very light in here. That very light. And just let that corner of the mouth just go a bit longer. And then we can actually get a bit more tone under the nose. Still fairly light, but it does need a bit more tone under there. So just using the grey-brown type colours, just bringing it down, even into the lip itself, just to link it all together. Start to get a bit of colour into the lips. A little bit of crimson, I think. Touch of crimson in the lips, and a bit of green just to knock it down. Generally, the top lip is darker than the lower one. Let's keep that shape a bit softer. The same on this side. Bit of colour. Even a bit of the indigo in there as well, just as a shadow colour with the red. Too bright, a bit duller. The corner of the mouth, keep it soft. Bit of yellow in there as well. link those colours together. A bit more red in the lower lip. On the side. Just soften that off a bit. And then a bit more red into the nose. And purples, red and purples. A bit of that edge of the nose in. Just let it diffuse up there. Touch of red on this side. Coming back to the eyes. Need to get more tone now into the eyes. So using this red, light red, just going to bring a bit more colour and contrast into the eyes. Building up a bit more depth in the eye fold. Perhaps a bit more in the shadow there. Definitely more in the shadows, kind of coming up the head. A bit more of the indigo and the burnt sienna together for the eyebrow, particularly where it goes into the hairline. Start to bring the eyebrow a bit stronger. As I get a bit more confident with where these marks are going, I can start to darken up the colours. that sienna. Just going to rub out a little bit of tone through here, just because there's a bit more light in the form. Even bring a little bit of green or more cerulean blue and yellow together. Greenier mix, work that in. Just to get the edge of the eyebrow working. And again, I need to do a little bit of rubbing out on the top of the eye, the brow ridge, because it's actually very light here. I can knock out a bit of the existing colour and also a little bit through here. Get a bit more light in there. A bit more cerulean. Just on the edge of that. Cool that edge down a bit more, and then just where it meets the hair here, it's a little bit lighter, so I'm just going to lift out a bit of colour there, just using some water and pushing the brush a little bit into the paper to lift out some of that paint. I can soften it down a bit. And then I need a little bit more softening in here. Get the eye working a bit better. There's some more light just on that edge of that shape, which needs to come out a bit more. And I need a tiny bit of bluey green just in here to turn the edge, make it go round a little bit more. Fill that in with a bit more of the blue and the green. Perhaps a bit of brown in there as well. Just to start to darken that up a bit more. On the edge where it's bumping up against the hair, it needs to be pretty dark. And then I'm going to jump back into the eye again. Before I do that, I'm just going to soften off that edge there. Knock a bit of colour out here. So I need a very pale pinky grey, bluey grey, just to come underneath the eye here, just to give the bottom of the eye a bit of shape. More warmth, a bit warmer colour. And just temper that. Making that shape a little bit less prominent. A little bit of bluey grey just on the edge of that shape. Pull that down a little bit lower to give the eye socket a bit more form. Bring a little bit of that light bluey wash in there. Or even lift out just a teeny bit of tone in there. And then I'm going to continue that same blue yellow kind of very light wash through the front of the cheek as that kind of links up with that shape that comes under the eye. Just very, very light washes just to tint the paper. Just manipulating it between warm and cool colours. So a bit warmer on the cheek line. As we're coming down into the jaw, it goes a bit cooler, a bit more green. Just to get it to start to turn down into the jaw. Into the shapes around the muscles and the shapes around the mouth. So a few more half tones, just little very, very subtle colours. Just in the chin. Perhaps a little bit more half tone just on the edge of the mouth here as it turns the corner. There are some very, very subtle colours in and around the nose. And then the wing of the nose needs to come a little bit browner. Perhaps a little bit of red in there as well. Start to build up the wing of this nose, nostril. Because it's actually lighter in the lower part of the nose. the cerulean on the edge here. Start to get this shadow shape in there. More cerulean again. So it's a bit darker in the form around the nose here. Just work that out into the existing colours. Slightly darker here. As it comes up into the eyebrow. Just a few little marks here and there. Half tone the edges and try and get the fur working slightly better. So a bit more blue now, just into the forehead. A little bit more red, the pinky red. Yellow in that. Well, it's very orange. Just want a few bits of orangey kind of colours within some of these existing tones that I've put on, just to break up and give her skin a little bit of variation and texture. A little bit of lifting out on the wing of the nose here, just to get a bit of variation. So that the nose doesn't look too flat. Just start to build some shape in and around the mouth. More tone under the neck. green. So a few more greener notes within the skin, and then I need to tidy up the eyes a bit more. So the eyes need a bit more work done to them. Just going to work into the eyes again. They're a little bit too big, and they need a touch more shadow in them. So the actual pupils themselves need a bit more tone in them. Just to strengthen these colours up more. That tone down the eye a bit. Just soften it off. Get the lower part of the eye a bit more tone. Which will help to A, reduce the size of the pupil, so the eye in general. Tone into the centre. Just a few more flicks of dark in the eye. Just to really help it pop a bit more. A little bit more dark just coming down the eyelash here. And then I'll do a little bit of that work out on this eye to get it a bit stronger. So again, starting at the top of the eye, taking the brownie colours. Let's drop those in. Just want to coax that shape out a little bit more. Down. Need a touch more burnt sienna in there to make it a bit warmer brown. Colour down a bit more. Some of the cerulean into that to glue it, glue the grey down a bit more. As the fold or the eyelash comes out to the right a bit more. Take a bit more of the red. All the red colours. Get it a bit stronger in here again. Just putting a bit of the colour down and then just manipulating it with a little bit of water. Just to push it around the shape that I want. A bit more on this side. More tone into the eye fold. A bit more blue in it, a bit more indigo. That indigo coming out on this side. into the shadow. Same over here. Perhaps a few of those brown indigo marks up in the eyebrow. Start to pull out a little bit of detail. Same on the other side, a few of those marks. Just using the damp brush to work them in. A little bit more shape in the eye there. And then start to work the nostrils. Just trying to find the shape of the nose first by lifting out a little bit of colour. Bigger brush for lifting out. A bit more tone in here. Just blot that off. Let that dry and then I'll add some more tone in there. A little bit more light just in there. In fact, to get the transparent yellow, tiny bit of yellow ochre, not too much. I don't want it to go too yellow. I want just a bit of very pale notes within the skin. And in places as well, I don't want it everywhere. It's just to help the lighter areas of the skin to be a lot brighter. Kind of pull some of these areas together by having a bit of a glaze into them. Slightly warmer. Just in here as it comes into the nose. slightly more yellow down there. Okay, now I'm going to dry that now and then get into the nostrils. So I'm going to try and get a bit of drawing into the nostril line now. Just taking a little bit of the purple, fairly light. I'm just going to try and nostril shape, which I think is about here. Sort of comes down. And the one on the other side is a similar shape. A bit of warmer colour in there. Light just bouncing in here. I'll lift a little bit of that out. Touch more dark. Not too much. Knock that down. I need to soften the edge off in a minute. I'll give that a quick dry. So that's now dry. So I'm going to just manipulate the shape of that now, just some water and a bit of lifting out. So it needs a bit more shape this way. Just soften the edge off a bit. Tiny bit more shadow just coming through the nose there. As I said before, there's a little bit more light just pushing up into the nostril. And a little bit of light on this side. Just knock it down a bit there. Just soften off some of these edges. bit more definition in the mouth. Tone in the nose, a few marks around the eye. A bit more green. So to finish up with, I'm just going to add a few more stronger pieces of tone and drawing marks, which will just pull the whole thing together, hopefully. So I'm going to take some burnt umber, burnt sienna, a little bit of indigo, really nice dark, browny dark. Get some stronger drawing marks in. So the hair kind of comes down the side of the face here. Using the paint fairly neat now, just to get some more of these definition marks in. Define the bottom of the chin a little bit. A couple of marks into the eyebrows. Going to give a bit more tone, just a tiny bit more tone to the eye. clean the brush off. Then I'm going to just dive into some white. So just using a little bit of white now. Add a few more bits of definition in the skin. Not too much, just a little bit. So dipping into a little bit of white. A little bit of green in there, perhaps a little bit of the light red. I'm going to bring a few just marks here and there, just to imply that she's got a bit of skin tone, texture. Into the eyebrow. Tiny bit more brown, red into that. Still pretty dry, so there's not too much water in this. Got quite a lot of freckles. Just a little bit of highlight over the eyes. Just a bit of white on its own now. Just to pull out some of these highlights. In the face. The brush off, it's getting a bit dirty. A few more little bits of white. A little bit of a highlight on the nose. A tiny bit in the filtering. A bit of white into the eye. Couple of little marks here and there, and I think that finishes the painting.